Joe Biden is deteriorating before our eyes. The president had another shocking week of gaffes that were broadcast across the globe as he humiliated himself on the world stage at the G7. Sky News All-Stars James Morrow, Rita Panahi and Alex Stein take a look at Joe Biden's rapid decline and ask what's next for the frail and feeble president. The Democrats are wheeling Joe Biden out to campaign in the hopes of raising money for the party in the lead up to the November election. But their efforts are backfiring. With all the publicity surrounding the president focused on his stumbles and mumbles rather than his policies. Like the Democrats' latest fundraiser in Los Angeles, where Joe Biden froze and needed help from Barack Obama to get off the stage, explained Sky News All-Star Rita Panahi.
The leader of the free world was in sterling form last night after a big Democrat fundraiser in LA with many A-listers there, the usual suspects, George Clooney, Julia Roberts, Barbara Streisand. Watch here as Barack Obama grabs Biden's arm and helps direct the confused POTUS off stage. We found out who the puppet master is. No wonder many savvy pundits consider this Obama's third term, and it's been his most disastrous yet.
Sky News All-Star Alex Stein agrees, saying no amount of money raised will make Joe Biden smarter or sharper, and he should be on a golf course, not running for president.
Let's bring in the host of Primetime with Alex Stein on Blaze TV. Alex, I'm interested on your thoughts on the Democrats' fundraiser with Obama in LA featuring Hollywood A-listers and Obama helping the president off stage. It's clear that the celebrities don't care about any sort of cognitive decline. The celebrity class is right behind President Biden.
Well, Rita, I believe George Clooney raised $30 million for Joe Biden, and it's sad because that money will not make him any smarter or any sharper. Basically, we're living in the weekend of Bernie's at this point. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm not even trying to say that it's a joke, but when Barack Obama has to guide him off set. And then what's even worse is you have like these TikTok influencers like Harry Sisson, who's literally defending this and saying that Joe Biden is 100% cognitive and that he's functioning like a normal adult. I mean, he's 80 years old. The guy deserves to be on a golf course, not running for president of the United States.
And just days earlier, Joe Biden completely humiliated himself at the G7 in Italy on numerous occasions, reveals Sky News All-Star James Morrow.
Now, of course, the footage that emerged early on from the event, including the bizarre spectacle of the U.S. president wandering off after a skydiving display and having to be wrangled back into line by his counterparts, other world leaders, was bizarre enough. And this led to amazed commentary from around the world, as well as this fantastic New York Post front page, Meander in Chief. That's him, folks. And then there was this uncomfortable moment when the president went in for an intimate forehead-to-forehead moment with the Holy Father, Pope Francis. As our good friends at the Babylon Breed Bee joked, Biden disappointed after a huge scoop of vanilla ice cream turns out to be Pope Francis. Tough luck, sir. Better luck next time. But this is, though, you know, all joking aside, serious stuff, or as the president would say, not a joke. Mm-hmm. Biden apparently, for reasons we can only speculate on, also skipped out on the official big G7 dinner with his other world leaders.
Interestingly, there seems to be a universal safety net around Joe Biden, with the leaders of the G7 jumping in to save the meandering president, trying to act like nothing strange is happening at all, explains James Morrow.
More urgent news to bring you about the apparent state of Joe Biden's mental acuity. Just hours ago, the president and other world leaders were in southern Italy for the G7 summit talks. and they enjoyed a little display of skydiving put on by their host, Giorgia Meloni. Now, that sounds straightforward, but with Joe Biden, things can get weird fast. Have a look at this and watch the way other world leaders jump in to save Biden and act like what he's doing here is perfectly normal. There's Ursula von der Leyen, there's Macron, there's Rishi Sunak, there's Meloni wrangling him back into line. No, 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 it's all good, Mr. President. Just look this way, perfectly normal. Yep, chuck on those sunnies. I mean, I'm sorry, the G7 is looking now less like a group of leaders of major industrialized economies than it is like a dysfunctional family where everyone just agrees to cover for their fading family member rather than admit there's a problem.
But according to insiders, Joe Biden's performance behind the scenes at the G7 was even more concerning than his on-camera gaffes.
As more concern mounted that his performance behind the scenes was even more woeful than what he was doing in public. The Sun's Harry Cole was there, and he reported that one diplomatic source said Biden was, quote, the worst he's ever been, and said Biden was fading in and out and going from being mentally sharp to totally out of it. Here's a bit more of what Cole, who reported from the summit, had to say.
Most G7 summits, diplomatic sprints, you expect to see the President of the United States, as other world leaders, doing a flurry of meetings. Has he been doing the same thing?
No, he ducked out of the dinner last night. And frankly, Jack, I'm gonna ruin my story for the paper tomorrow by telling it to never mind the ballots. But my sources, diplomatic sources here, people I've been speaking to, say it's the worst they've ever seen Joe Biden.
Wow.
And he's in a bad way, and he's losing focus in meetings. Sometimes he's very sharp, sometimes he's very much not. So some worrying developments there.
Pretty damning stuff, frankly.
Alex Stein agrees, saying Joe Biden's G7 performance shows he's clearly senile and being juiced up on performance-enhancing drugs.
Joe Biden is a hypocrite. Joe Biden is basically senile at this point. And like you said, there are 80-year-olds that are still quick-witted and still got it going on, but Joe Biden is not that guy. I believe that he's probably hopped up on some sort of amphetamine, or he's on some sort of medication that actually, keeps his energy up. But obviously, he's artificially on performance-enhancing drugs. And I know that might sound crazy, but there's no way that this guy would have the fortitude to travel to all these places and do all this stuff if they weren't juicing him up with, I don't know what that is, but it's pretty obvious that he's not on just coffee, in my opinion.
And following the disastrous G7 performance, Joe Biden returned to the US only to lose his cool with a TikTok influencer, which was all captured on camera.
Now, overnight, new footage has emerged of the president losing it at a recent White House event to court support from social media influencers. Let's see how that went for him.
And I know you're a typical press guy. You're grabbing me in front of this all this. I trust you as far as I throw your phone. I have a good arm, man.
Absolutely.
I can throw a long way. But my point is this.
Wow.
Yeah, he's got a good arm there, man, and he don't trust you until you can throw your phone. I don't know, honestly. And he's not afraid to use that good arm, I suppose. But here's the rest of the exchange, which saw aides have to swoop in and break up the confrontation, I don't know, before Biden went all corn pop.
I have made very clear to the Israelis what they have to do in the near term. If they don't, what's going to happen?
So what's going to happen? Why? Is the U.S. going to cut off funding?
I came because usually you tell me I have a nice suit and you didn't comment on my suit today, so I felt a little offended.
No.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Second, sir, please. Thank you.
I guess the president had to go bang his razor blade in a rusty barrel or something out the back and get a length of chain.
So, what does Joe Biden's continued deterioration mean for the upcoming presidential debates? James Morrow weighs in.
Now, I bring this up not just to highlight the president's decline, which is real and important, but because how this is managed is crucial to the rapidly accelerating 2024 presidential campaign. The first presidential debate, which is happening soon, just a couple of weeks from now on June 27. Now, talked to people in Washington, and they are saying a few things, all variations on this theme. Namely that, A, the early debate gives the Democrats a chance to, if things go really wrong for Biden, swap the president out and put another candidate in before or at the Chicago convention a few weeks later. The other thing, B, that if he does well, if Biden does well, the debate will put a new zing in the step of the Democrat campaign and put to rest, for a moment, all the Biden dementia rumors. Well, what to say about that? First of all, presidential debates generally don't have that much of an effect on campaign outcomes, so perhaps this is all a bit of an academic question. But secondly, and this is another key question, which Joe Biden are we going to get at the debate? Look, if the president's got neurological issues, there are ways his doctors can help him get through set pieces. Like, for example, the State of the Union address, which, as Samuel Johnson once said, in a different context, Biden's performance was like a dog walking on its hind legs. Not done well, but you were surprised to find it done at all. Because lately, we seem to get one of two Bidens. The manic, overclocked Biden who gibbers like a neurotic house cat after eight espressos, and the nearly catatonic Biden who just stares at you like a deer that has just made its way onto the Hume Highway.